Hey guys, let's continue in this new video on talking about radical catalyzed halogenation. So, free radical chain reaction or radical catalyzed halogenation, all it's really doing here, we're going to say under this reaction, a hydrogen from an alkane is replaced by a halogen. And the halogen that we usually use is either bromine or chlorine. Iodine is too slow and fluorine is way too reactive. If fluorine tried to form a bond, the compound would actually explode. So we're going to say here that in this radical chain reaction, alkanes will react with diatomic halogens, so Cl2 or Br2, in the presence of heat or UV light. And we're going to say here that when it comes to this process, there are three basic steps to a radical chain reaction. The first step is initiation. Here, a stable compound undergoes homolytic cleavage. So homolytic cleavage just means, so let's say we're dealing with Br. Remember, Br halogens, when not in the center, make single bonds to one another. Now, in homolytic cleavage, the bond between them breaks evenly. Each of them brought to the table one electron. And in homolytic cleavage, that bond breaks and each halogen leaves with the electron it came in with. So we go from having zero radicals to having two radicals at the end. What's a radical? A radical is when you have an electron that is not paired. It's just a lone electron. So where's our radical electron? This is our radical electron and this is our radical electron. Electrons normally are found paired up. Like all these examples here, they're paired up. But a radical reaction, a radical itself, doesn't have an electron to pair up with. It's just by itself. These are extremely dangerous and very reactive compounds. You hear talks in the news about free radicals, how they damage your skin. This is what they're talking about. The sun actually, because of the UV rays, UVA and UVB, cause a mutation on your skin where you create free radicals on the surface. This can lead to cancers. This can lead to a lot of different maladies. So this is what they're talking about. Now, in propagation, also called the chain reaction step, so when you hear talks of chain reactions, they're talking about the propagation step. One of these radicals here basically reacts with our alkane, CH4. So we have a radical, a stable compound. They react together to form a new radical and a new stable compound. So basically what happens here is that Br comes in and basically kicks out one of the hydrogens. So now it's CH3Br plus the H I kicked out. So we created a new normal compound and a new radical. That is propagation. And in this step, this can happen multiple times. And we can say that this happens multiple times until every single hydrogen would be replaced with a Br. Now it's hard to do this, and usually we just do one monohalogenation. We just usually replace one hydrogen with one halogen. But it is possible to try to replace every single hydrogen here with a Br to wind up with CBr4 at the end. But here, if that did happen, your professor would make it clear. They would say, oh, replace all the hydrogens with halogens. And then finally, we have the last step of a radical reaction, which is called termination. Termination is the opposite of initiation. In initiation, we have one compound breaking up into two radicals. In termination, we have the opposite. Two radicals combine together to form a new stable compound. So this H radical that got ejected, and remember, we only use one of these Br radicals. There's still another one floating around. So that H radical and that Br radical could somehow find each other and form HBr. So you have two radicals here, each with one unpaired electron that desperately needs to be paired up. So what do? They just meet up and have their electrons form a bond to one another. And so now they're stable. So these are the steps of any radical reaction: initiation, propagation, termination. It's important to know what their terms mean, and also what's most important, what each one forms. So in initiation, we form two radicals. In propagation, we form a radical and a new compound. And in termination, we get rid of all our radicals to create one new stable compound. So just remember this. And on the next page, we'll take a look at different types of radical chain reactions. So remember, All that happens here is we're going to do monohalogenation on the following questions. So we're going to replace a hydrogen with one halogen based on the number of types of hydrogens present. So take a look at the next questions and then we'll go over them together. So click on the next video and see how I tackle each one.